Welcome back to the Fenrir Rottweiler Show, and today I'm super pumped to be catching up with Manny as he discusses all about why he chose the breeder for his glorious Rottweiler.
Hey guys, welcome yet to another video, and today I want to talk to you guys about how did I find Ivy. So the process I went through to find the perfect breeder and to find the perfect puppy. I will just tell you behind the scene everything, and I break down everything for you, and eventually this can help you for your decision. When we finally decided that we wanted to bring home a Rottweiler, we decided on the breed and we were sure about it, I started to select all type of breeders. So we were just around December, which in Australia is basically start of summer, actually it's already summer. So I thought it was the perfect moment to bring home a puppy, because I don't want to bring home a puppy in winter, toilet trainer under the rain or 0 Celsius degrees outside, even though here it's pretty hot as compared to Europe, yet. In winter can get pretty cold in Australia, especially in Melbourne. I didn't want to have to toilet train a puppy, stand up at 2 in the morning, freezing or under the rain. I thought that if I could help myself to make this a bit smoother and a bit easier, I would have done so. So I decided to go in December. I decided to start to have a look for a puppy, and I went on the Australian official website of the ACNC registered breeder, and I had a look of every single breeder and every single page and website that they offer. I had a look at all the previous litter that they have. I had a look at the males that we have at the beach, or the female that they breed, and the puppy, how they turn out, and that's just for the look of the puppy. In terms of how serious a breeder is, you can clearly, first thing first, a serious breeder that wanna sell you a Rottweiler or any type of powerful breed, it will not just send you a price and that's it. It will first of all ask about yourself, about your living situation, about your family, how space do you have in your backyard, what's your time, what's your schedule of the day, and just make sure that you could be a right owner for one of their puppy. So if a breeder before everything asks you this, is a good sign, is a reputable breeder and someone that actually cares about where their puppy is going to, and not just someone that wanna make money and keep breeding, like exhausting the female just to make money out of the puppy. So this is the first thing. I had a look at only the breeders that were actually, before everything, there was a form to fill up and kind of a questionnaire to fill up about all your details, and then eventually they would have given something back to you. So I did this, and unfortunately there were no litter available in Victoria, which is the state I live in. Try to have a look and extend to the near state here. So I went to see New South Wales, is where Sydney is, and South Australia. And they were all sold out. There was no litter and no waiting list available. I was pretty sad back then, because I said, damn, this is the perfect moment. We are ready to bring home a puppy. And of course, when you want to bring home a new puppy, you kind of want it as soon as possible. And please don't make the mistake to make this rush into a decision, and don't make this decision and this rush eventually get you the wrong puppy. So my suggestion is, I know it's very hard, and you want a puppy like this afternoon, not even wait until tomorrow. You wanna go and pick up your puppy today, but you need to make sure that you're picking the right puppy. This puppy is gonna last you for 10, 8 to 12 years average. So you don't wanna rush, even though every puppy deserves a nice home, but you want to pick the right puppy and the right breeder. So I luckily found one that I really, really liked. It was in South Australia. One of the breeder I contacted say, unfortunately, all her litter was sold out, and even the next two plan were sold out. So the waiting list would have been for over a year. And of course, I didn't want to wait over a year. But she gave me the contact for these other breeders that she's super recommended. Say, no, go for this one. She does exactly how it has to be done. She's a ACNC breeder registered. She just breeds once or twice a year maximum. she doesn't overbreed, she's doing competition, there's this pedigree line and everything. So of course I got curious, I contact this breeder and I ask all the information. She asked me all the information about me and my family, which it was a very good sign. And I asked, of course, to see the parents. Here we were communicating by emails and phone. We did a few FaceTime calls and I've seen the parents. I've seen the previous litters. I had a look at everything I could, all the qualifications she won and everything. And I was pretty happy about it. And she had a litter that was due in April. Sorry, she had a litter that was due in February. Here we are about December. So I did put one of the puppy on I put myself in a waiting list for one of the puppy. I was after a female. In the next video I will tell you why I was after a female, not on a male, and the difference between the male and the female in the Rottweiler, because there is difference between the two. And so back to what I was talking about, I was after a female and she say I should definitely have a female. So far you only have one person in front of you and he wants a male, so 99% of the chance, you know, you're gonna get a female. So super happy. Of course she said we will help you to pick the puppy. I had two cats. I was looking for a female that was on a spectrum from super lazy and super laid down to super active, and so 10 and 1. I was looking for something probably 6, kind of in the middle of the spectrum, and she perfectly agreed with me. I told her, of course, I had experience with the Rottweiler, so she said you can also get a female that is a bit more. But I didn't want to get a female that was too excited or too high on the spectrum, just because I had two cats and my girlfriend never had a big dog, powerful breed. And so I just decided I don't want to take any chance. I want to make sure to get home the perfect puppy for all the family, not just for myself. And so we were asking for something between 5 and 6 on a spectrum from 1 to 10. So we booked in the puppy. She said when the puppy will be around 5 to 6 weeks old, we will be able to pick the puppy for you, not anytime earlier. Before, we're gonna see the personality of the puppy, but around 6 weeks, you will be able to actually pick your own puppy, and we will be actually able to be, okay, this is the puppy for you, this is not the puppy for you, this will be this and this will be that. So super excited, put down my deposit, and then COVID started, the state shut down, and the puppy I could not leave my state, and the transport, we had a look at the transport as well. Unfortunately they shut down everything, so I was with no puppy whatsoever. So super disappointed and super sad. I was like, damn, what I'm gonna do now? It's COVID started, we prepare everything and puppy's not gonna come. So we were like 3 weeks away from the day to the pickup, and yeah, everything shut down. And so super sad. I was like, well, it's fine. But I didn't give up, and I got actually very lucky, because as for me, my puppy could not travel in Victoria from South Australia. Puppy that were in Victoria, that were being booked before me, they could not travel outside. So one of the first breeder I did actually contact, Ben, in December, which she is a international Rottweiler judge. She only breed a super high quality and a super high lineage of Rottweiler. She just based on the temperament, of course, and the look, she does show. She knows the breed deeply. And that was actually one of my first pick when I first started to reach out for breeder. Of course all the litter were sold out, but there was just one puppy left that it was meant to fly to New Zealand, which she didn't because of course of the restriction. And so she gave something back to me because she liked the way I approached her in the first place, explaining who I was, I had experience with the Violet first, why did I choose her as a breeder, that I had a look in her website, I did a back search of her and what she did and what she didn't. I did have a look of all the previous litter and how did it turn out, the parents, the puppies and everything. So she really liked these, and so she contacted me. She said, hey, I know you were after a female, I have this female, this is her temperament, what do you think? And I said, damn, this is exactly what I was looking for. And so luckily enough, after 2 weeks I was able to go and pick up Ivy, which is the one I have today. I could not be happier with the choice. I got lucky, and it seems a bit rushed, as in she contacted me 2 weeks after I went to pick up the puppy. I didn't have any pick over the litter because of course only her came up available, all the other were driving to pick up the puppy. But luckily the puppy that got available was exactly the puppy I was looking for, so it turned out well for me. So if this happened to you guys as well, good enough. wise, don't rush in the decision. Just wait for the next litter or wait for the next breeder. But just make sure you bring home the perfect puppy for yourself. And most important, you want to make sure he's the right breeder and not just a backyard breeder. And just so you know, guys, backyard breeders is not just someone that cross animals like this just to make money. Backyard breeders is considered also like, if I was to breed ivy with no knowledge of how to breed ivy. So I really love my dog. Maybe another person is a male, he really loves his dog. They both have pedigree, they both have a very high lineage, but together we just decide to breed. That is also considered a backyard breeder. So doesn't matter that we love the dog as much, but a reputable breeder knows exactly the genetic he's breeding, know exactly why he's breeding that female with that male, and they kind of know what type of puppy they're expecting from it. A reputable breeder knows and value and consider this as well when he breeds a dog with another, why he picked that male for this female, try to make them compatible, or for example, if she's trying to get in the new litter something, for example, she wants to get the new breeds a bit bigger or a bit smaller or whatever, she knows why she's breeding that dog with the other. And that is something that it's kind of give you reassurance of your dog being a good dog. Of course, simplest thing, the parents are all being tested for hip dysplasia and score and everything, so you know that at least the parents are free from any type of genetic issues. Then everything can happen. We see poor Will with this poor kind of course, so what happened, but at least going for a reputable breeder, you try to reduce at the minimum any chance of risk you could have to have any problem with your puppy. And you also make sure you know the breeder is doing the right things before they are 8 weeks of age, because that is also important. Like, you want to make sure that the breeder knows what he's doing with your puppy before the 8 weeks of age, so before you going to pick up your puppy, he's been well socialized, the mom is doing the right thing, he's been feeding in the right way, have been exposed to different type of scenes and scenario. My breeder was there with other animals, so kids, animals, perfect, she was socialized, other dogs, it was great, everything was great, perfect, and the most high quality food. It's everything that comes with picking the right puppy. And I suggest you guys to do the same. Don't rush in any decision, no matter what type of dog you guys gonna be. It can be a Rottweiler, it can be a Mastiff, it can be a Cane Corso, it could be a Pitbull, it could be any type of breed, it can even be a French Bulldog. Just make sure you pick the right breeder and you pick the right puppy. So guys, for today's video is enough. Please let me know down in the comment if you want to know absolutely anything. Just don't be afraid to comment, just whatever you want to need, ask a question. I will be happy to answer to anything you guys want. If you want to follow on Instagram, it's IvyTheRot. And see you next time. Cheers. Don't forget to subscribe.
As always, thank you so much, Manny, for sharing all of that knowledge, information, tips and tricks with us and our audience. It's really appreciated. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe and turn on that notification bell. That way you'll never miss one of our future videos here on the Fenrir Rottweiler Show.